Most people are looking for a simple solution to build muscle in a fast and efficient way. The bottom line, so to speak. And I gotta say, it doesn't get much simpler than this, because after spending a lot of time building muscle naturally, I learned there are certain exercises that you should avoid entirely, other exercises that you might want to consider incorporating, and there are those other exercises that you just can't do without. I've narrowed this list down to just the 7 most important exercises that you absolutely should have as a staple part of your routine to efficiently build the most muscle in the shortest amount of time possible. By just doing these 7 key compound exercises, you'll see incredible results without doing anything else in the gym. And I made this video specifically for men, not because women can't benefit from these exercises as well, but because the ideal attractive body type for men is a V-shape, whereas for women, it's more of an hourglass figure. So even though a lot of these exercises do cross over for both men and women, this video is specifically to help you develop the best physique with the least amount of exercises possible. Let's start first with a very important upper body exercise, the barbell row. With this exercise, you'll be working the rhomboids, which are the muscles that connect your shoulder blades together, so your upper back muscles. You'll also be working the back of your shoulders and your biceps. This is one of the most important pulling movements that you can do other than the deadlift. Because you're working multiple muscle groups responsible for pulling, you're able to lift a lot more weight with this compound exercise than if you were to isolate any one of these muscles individually. By strengthening your rhomboids and your posterior deltoid, you'll be tightening up your upper back, which will help you hold yourself up straight and vertical and maintain a better upright posture. Due to the fact that you're lifting heavy weight, your biceps are also going to get plenty of stimulation with a weight that would be literally impossible to lift with isolation movements like bicep curls. A basic row is done by grabbing a barbell with your hands a little wider than shoulder width apart. Stick your butt out and stick your chest out before beginning the movement. Then bend down by about 60 degrees, so you're a little higher than being fully parallel to the ground, and you want to let the weight hang straight down. Don't flex your shoulders. While keeping your chest out, pull the barbell in towards your stomach and aim for your belly button. Then bring it back down to that hanging position that you started at and repeat this motion for reps. The great thing about rows is that you can do it with a barbell or you could do it with dumbbells. Also, by changing the angles at which you bend, you can target different parts of your back. A fully bent over position where you're pulling the weight to your chest at a 90 degree angle will target more of your lats and the middle of your back, whereas standing more upright will target more of your traps and your upper back. Let's move on to another staple exercise that you should be doing. Barbell and dumbbell chest presses. While the rows will help you develop the posterior or the back part of your upper body, the chest presses are going to be there to help you develop the anterior or the front part of your upper body. It'll help you develop your chest, the front head of your shoulders, as well as your triceps. With chest presses, you want to spend the majority of your time doing them at 2 different angles, flat and incline. If your weakness is your upper chest, you want to spend more of your time doing incline presses. If your upper chest is fine but you lack lower chest development, you want to spend more of your time doing flat movements. Now, the reason why I didn't mention the decline angle is because with flat presses, you're going to get more benefits for your whole chest, including your lower chest, than you would get from decline presses. And you'll be able to get a better pump while traveling through a fuller range of motion. To perform a basic chest press, you'll want to lie right under a barbell, unrack the bar, and bring it over your nipple line. If you're doing the incline press, you'll be aiming for a couple inches above your nipple line. Make sure your elbows are not too far flared out, and they're also not too tight to your ribs. You want them at about a 45 degree angle between your body and your elbows. Lower the bar to your nipple line, or slightly above if you're doing incline, and then press back up to the starting position, trying to move the bar in as straight of a line up and down as possible while squeezing the bar tight with your hands. The amount of development you can get for your chest, the front of your shoulders, and your triceps from this one exercise is truly amazing, and I would argue that this is one of the best exercises for all 3 of those muscle groups, especially since this is going to be one of your most powerful upper body pressing exercises, allowing you to load all 3 of these muscles with a lot of weight. Let's move on to a lower body exercise that just can't be ignored. Barbell squats. If I could choose just one weight training exercise that gives you the most benefits for your lower body, I couldn't think of a better exercise than the squat. With this one exercise, you can target pretty much your whole lower body, including your glutes, your quads, as well as your hamstrings, calves, and even your lower back. But it doesn't just stop there. Doing squats with heavy weight can help strengthen your central nervous system, it can help increase testosterone, and stimulate the production of growth hormone, allowing you to lift heavier weights for all your other exercises and allowing you to build more muscle throughout your whole body. Squats are a very natural movement that I firmly believe anybody can perform with enough time and practice, but they have to be performed correctly or else not only will you not get the benefits, but you can also wind up with a serious injury. To do this correctly, you want to start by placing both your hands a little wider than shoulder width apart on the barbell. Then get your head under the bar and rest the bar on your traps, which is the upper part of your back. You don't want to rest the bar on your neck. As you bend your knees and squat down, you want to make sure that you're sticking your butt out and your chest out to protect your lower back and maintain a neutral spine. As you're lowering yourself down, you also want to make sure that you're sticking your butt back and keeping your weight a little more on your heels rather than your toes. For newbies, I tell them to keep all their weight on their heels because most beginners have the common problem of putting too much weight on their toes during their squat, which makes their knees cross way too far over their toes and can lead to a knee injury. This is partially because a lot of beginners are afraid to allow their backs to bend as they do the squat while still maintaining that neutral curve in their spine. Instead, they try to keep their backs perfectly straight and vertical. This is not the correct way to perform a squat. Don't be afraid to allow your back to bend while keeping your head up and your chest turned out and pointed forward. If you're just looking to target your quads, you can lower yourself to 90 degrees and then stand back up. But if you're looking to target more of your glutes, you can lower yourself past 90 degrees. Just make sure that your form is perfect before attempting what we call ass to the grass squats. The whole time that you do this exercise, you want to try to lower and raise the bar once again in a straight line. If you're new to doing squats with a barbell, it's a good idea to put either a platform or a bench behind your heels for you to squat down to. If you think about simply sitting down onto this platform and standing back up rather than thinking about squatting, it can actually help you develop proper squat form when you're ready to do it without the bench. Let's move on. For the next exercise, we're gonna go back to the upper body with by far one of the best exercises to give you that V-taper appearance, the pull-up. Now, if you can't do pull-ups, don't worry. I'm gonna give you a couple other options that can work just as well. But once you can build up enough strength to do the pull-ups, you're gonna wanna definitely be doing this exercise. Pull-ups will primarily work your lats and your biceps, as well as focus a little bit on your upper back. But the number one thing that'll help you develop is that V-shape. By building up your lats and making them bigger, that's exactly what will give you that desirable V-shape frame that you constantly see on athletes and muscular Hollywood actors. It's important to note that I'm not talking about chin-ups here. Chin-ups are where you take a close underhand grip, roughly shoulder width apart, and pull yourself up. Chin-ups will work much more of your biceps rather than your lats. With pull-ups, you want to take a wider overhand or pronated grip of the pull-up bar. The wider you can spread your arms out, the more you'll target your lats. But keep in mind, the wider you go, the harder the exercise will get. You want to aim for a grip that makes it look like you're trying to make a Y shape with your arms. Stick your chest out and pull yourself up while keeping your elbows flared out. The goal is to pull your body up until your chin fully clears over the bar and then lower yourself back down. Once you master doing pull-ups with your body weight, try to add additional weight on a belt or between your legs to increase intensity over time. If you can't do pull-ups with your body weight, you can strengthen all the same muscle groups with a lat pull-down, or you can use either resistance bands or a pull-up machine to assist you with this exercise. Next, for our fifth exercise, we have the deadlift. While squats focus more on your glutes and your quads, deadlifts will help you target your hamstrings a whole lot more. However, deadlifts don't only work your hamstring, they also work your quads, your inner thighs, your lower back, your rhomboids, and your traps. Because so many large, powerful muscles are involved, you can once again lift a really heavy weight, allowing you to stimulate more testosterone and more growth hormone production. It's also one of those staple exercises that, just like squats, will help strengthen your central nervous system and improve your overall strength and power output, transferring over benefits to almost all of your other weight training exercises. Start by standing in front of a loaded barbell with your feet a little wider than shoulder width apart. Stick your butt out, stick your chest out, sit back, bend your knees, reach down and grip the barbell right outside of your shins. Look up at the ceiling as you drive your chest up and hinge your hips inward. Lower the bar back down while still keeping your head up, your chest forward, and your butt out, and you have the option of either tapping the barbell on the ground or stopping about midway down your shins right before hitting the ground. Then come back up and repeat for reps. The deadlift works more muscles than any other exercise, including the squat. Not only will it help you develop a nicer lower body, but it'll also help you develop a wider and more muscular back, helping you achieve that V-taper look. Up next are shoulder presses. These are extremely effective whether you're using dumbbells or if you're doing military presses with a barbell. But just like other exercises already discussed, you'll typically be able to build more mass with a barbell. Shoulder presses will allow you to work the front and the lateral head of your shoulder while also incorporating your triceps, traps, and rotator cuff. Since this is one of the best exercises you can do to build the lateral head of your shoulder, it can help you widen out your upper body, once again giving you more of that V-taper appearance. When performing a barbell shoulder or military press, start by gripping the barbell wider than shoulder width with your arms in that wide position from before. Lower the bar in a straight line down to ear level or bring it right under your chin before returning the bar back up. You can go all the way down to your upper chest with this exercise, but I recommend only doing that with lighter sets. Using a heavier weight load and stopping under your chin will help you build more muscle. I highly recommend that you lower the bar in front of your head, not behind. Some experts still continue pushing the myth that going behind the head is more beneficial. From a muscle building standpoint, there is no mechanical advantage to going behind the head. You'll be forced to lift less weight while increasing your risk of injury to your neck and shoulders. Stick to keeping the barbell in front of you. You can do this exercise seated or standing, but seated presses will allow you to lift more weight, helping you build more shoulder mass. Also with the dumbbells, you can do variations of this exercise like the Arnold press that will allow you a greater range of motion. The last exercise on my list is the power clean. Not only will this exercise work almost every single muscle in your body, but most people completely forget that cleans and snatches are some of the best exercises to build a nicer back. On top of that, you'll increase explosive power in a way unlike any other exercise. Start with the barbell in front of your shins with your feet roughly shoulder width apart. Keep your head up, your chest out, and your butt out while grabbing the bar outside of your shins. While keeping the bar close to your body, you want to drive straight up and explode using your hips and your hamstrings. Drive your elbows under the bar and rack the bar on your shoulders along your collarbone with your elbows pointed forward. From there, lower back down and either touch the ground or stop midway down your shins before exploding back up and repeating the movement. That's it, guys. These are truly the only 7 exercises that you need to build a very nice, well-rounded physique. When I get extremely busy or when there's an emergency and I just don't have as much time as I normally do to commit to working out, or when I'm on vacation, these are literally the exercises that I do to ensure that I maintain and build more muscle while spending the least amount of time in the gym. I hope this video has helped you out. If you enjoyed it, make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit that bell icon so you can get notified whenever I release more free tips and tricks to help you build more muscle and burn more fat. Also, for those of you that are looking for a done-for-you program that'll help you burn fat and build muscle faster than ever, visit my website where we're running challenges designed to help you build more muscle and burn more fat faster than ever in only 6 weeks. You're gonna get a workout plan, a custom diet plan, as well as an accountability coach to help mentor and guide you through the entire process. This takes all the guesswork out and helps you hit your goals without any of the grueling trial and error that just wastes your time. On average, the clients that have a goal of losing body fat during our 6-week challenge are losing 20 pounds or 5% of their body fat, and those that have the goal of building muscle are gaining 5% lean mass in only 6 weeks. To find out more about our 6-week challenge, you can click the link somewhere around here, or you can visit my website directly at gravitytransformation.com. I'll see you guys soon. Pump it.